Hello. I've been teaching with some students in the classroom and other students learning from home now for a while, and I wanted to share with you my seven key tips for mixed mode learning. The first tip is to imagine that all of your students are online. Ensure that the resources you make are accessible to every student equally. You're aiming for equality between the students in the classroom and those learning online. The easiest way I've found to do that is to place all resources in a class OneNote. With my class OneNote, I have sections where the students can place their work, and because I put resources online, they can access them digitally equally no matter where their location. My second tip is to set very clear expectations. Lay out your objectives and make expectations explicit and ensure that all students can access them. I've done that by making announcements in a class team. This is my class team, and I have used an at mention to mention the group, which means that everyone will get a notification when I make this post. Thirdly, and importantly, you should consider your online students' socialization. Try and create opportunities for the online students to collaborate with students in the classroom. Here, one of my online students was collaborating with some students in the classroom on a practical activity. They were sharing the data and analysing it together. There are other ways that people can work together. For example, more than one user can collaborate on a document in real time. So during a lesson, students remotely and in the classroom can work on a presentation or a document together. I've already mentioned using the Teams channel, and I would make that so important to make it a tip. If you're going to have a meeting with a student, I would host it in the channel. Down here under Meeting Options, click Add Channel and then add the General tab of one of those channels. Now that means that anyone in the class can see it, and it also means that any recordings you make will be posted back to the channel and all the chat will be maintained together. I've also used the mentions, as I said before, to notify people in that channel. My fifth tip is to plan your direct instruction. You can either deliver direct instruction at the same time. I wear a Bluetooth microphone or a pair of headphones like these, which means that the remote students can hear me quite clearly wherever I am in the classroom. You can repeat the direct instruction for the distant students separately by going to your computer to talk to them, or you could pre-record some direct instruction, for example, in a video. Now, you don't need to pre-record it. You could find direct instruction from other teachers, for example, physics videos from my YouTube channel. My second, sixth tip is to support distant students separately. For example, you might want to mute your microphone when you're supporting the students in the classroom and then check in with the distant students at a specific time. It could be at the end of the lesson, or it could be at a predetermined time during the lesson. Sometimes I'll check in with my distant students at the end of the lesson, or sometimes at a later time, just to check how they're going with work that they're doing. My final tip is to record your lesson. In a Meet Teams call, just click the three dots and start recording. The students can replay, and anyone who's unable to attend can catch up, and it gives you a permanent record of what you've done. Hope that helps.